Hey guys, so boy, it is a nice day today on Monday, December 15th, 2014. Really nice. There's not even a cloud in the sky. Yep. A little bit windy, but not too bad. I thought that today, thought I'd do a drive video on my car. So I guess you could call this video Cruising in the Cruze, which that's what this is. So this is my 2014 Chevy Cruze 2.0 TD. TD means turbo diesel, that I bought in September, just almost 3 months ago. I bought it the day before the first day of fall, and it's definitely been a great one. I washed it last week, and it's a little bit dirty though, just from some of the rain that we just got from yesterday. I ordered some wipe new tire shine, and this, believe it or not, the tires are still shiny. They're not quite as shiny as the black magic stuff that I previously used, but they're still nice and shiny. They're supposed to stay shiny for up to 6 months, and so they'll at least be all nice and shiny like this until the springtime. So yeah, so I guess that without further ado, we'll do that since it's my day off today. I am have a little bit of free time for a couple days. So it's a cold start. Last running since early yesterday morning. So it's a cold start. It's only 57 degrees out. Turn the radio off because YouTube don't like no music being played. And last Monday I put diesel in this, and throughout worked for 5 days last week. That's only the amount of fuel that I used up in this. Not too bad. So the car now has 2,546 miles. Okay, so let me get my seatbelt on here. We'll go for a little drive here. Take her out on the highway. Gotta love that backup camera. Just gotta wait for these cars coming. way. You can probably tell this looks so much different now. Tell right there, brand new bridge. Yeah, they've actually widened up the highway. And they actually have a toll lane on it now. Past that truck. Yeah, this looks so much different. Definitely spent a few years on working on all of this. Glad that it's all done now. Came across this QT, and way over there, I know it's hard to see, but price of gas is $2.16 a gallon. Yep, so gas is cheap down here in Texas. Huh, even the price of diesel's even fallen. Huh, shows that diesel is $2.99 over at that QT. See, I just put diesel in my mother's car last night. I usually don't go to this station because it's sort of at a bad spot, kind of hard to get in and out of. I usually go over to Walmart to buy diesel for my car and my mother's car. So they had diesel for about $3.08 a gallon. So that's not too bad. Usually for me, in order to get on the highway now, you gotta like go right over the bridge to this street and then kind of go from that way over there. Yeah. Oh, and I got a call. Yep, that's my car phone. I don't even know who that number is. I'm not gonna answer it. Just decline. Yeah, that's the only way you can only get on the highway, though. Unless if you're on the toll lane. But I'm not getting on the toll lane because I don't have a toll tag on my car. So this is how I have to get on the highway. Which I don't really mind it. I'm actually doing a drive video while on the highway. So this is State Highway 121. There's some of y'all already know that live in the DFW area. So this is the northbound. This is the way that I go when I go to work. So I drive on this highway every single day. So I guess while we're that way, I guess I'll show y'all my workplace. Cars are slowing down here. It's about 11:30 a.m. though, so practically almost into the lunch hour at most workplaces. Well, now we're in Grapevine. And way over there to the left, y'all won't be able to see it, is a classic Chevrolet. That's where I bought this car at. It's way over there. Which y'all won't be able to see it. You go over this bridge just to get over there to classic Chevrolet. This egg. Main Street that goes right into downtown Grapevine. And at this intersection right here was where I got rear-ended by that stupid idiot that wasn't paying no attention on what he was doing. It was right at this intersection when I rear-ended my Grand Am, and that's why I don't have it anymore. And just way over yonder right there, you can see the Mercedes-Benz symbol right there. Park Place Motor Cars. That's where my brother works at, and also that's the same place where my mother bought her GLK 250 at. Yep, that's where she, that's where we got the Mercedes-Benz at. So there's the Great Wolf Lodge. And over there is Gaylord Texan. So over at that this stoplight right here, you turn right to go into Great Wolf Lodge, and then you turn left to go into the Gaylord. Look how nice they have the entrance all decorated. Well, they decorated up really good. Looks really good though in the daytime. It's usually dark whenever I drive through here every day because I do work night shifts. All right, so now we're in Coppell. My workplace is actually right next door to this warehouse right here. Now if only, there we go, get the green light now. There, Amazon Fulfillment. Yep. That's where I work at. Been working there since March. Definitely a great place to work at. Also, turn right on this road right here. This street right here is called Freeport Parkway. So if we make a right turn, my mother's workplace is just right over there. So my mother and I, we work pretty close together. Alright, now I'm going to get on the highway here. Just way over yonder over there is my mother's workplace. That's it over there. Yep, so this is Interstate Highway 635.
To the left.
left over there. Oh yeah, you see that plant over there? That's where my dad works at. Yep. Right. Let me make a little drive-by over at the house that my great-great-aunt lived just before she passed away. There's the house right there. So let me turn around from right here, because I don't want to pull in that driveway, because that driveway is a little, the slope on that driveway is a little bit too steep. Yeah, it's kind of a little awkward on how the way it is. I don't like how the way it is. So, we'll just stop here. And just give you all a little quick tour from outside. Can't give y'all a tour from inside the house because I don't have the keys to the house, but I can give y'all just a tour just on the outside. Boy, you can sure see all the leaves down now. Yeah, came down from the trees. See, these are oak trees. Looks like all these leaves may have came from this tree right here, from this house right next door. And yeah, actually this house originally it belonged to my great grandparents. Yeah, that's, this house is originally. So my great grandmother had lived in this house just until her health started getting real bad and eventually passed away 10 years ago. And then my grandmother decided to move my great-great-aunt into this house. And so she stayed in this house until she passed away earlier this year, which would be this past summer. And let's get into the backyard. This is a pretty big backyard. Actually, the last time I made a video over here was, let's see, early June, which was the last time I saw my great-great-aunt alive. And then it was just a few days after I made that video and she passed away. That was just on my grandfather and I doing some cutting on a broken limb from this elm tree right here. Got some honeybees on the dandelions here. Sure hadn't grown that much since the last time I cut it. I probably hadn't even cut this grass probably since either September or October. I'm gonna say October because I know I have at least cut it just once ever since I bought my Chevy Cruze. So I would say October at least. It probably could use a little grooming, but I don't think my grandparents aren't too worried about it. So I probably won't cut it anymore this year, probably until spring, either March or April. It's a pretty big yard though. to me, I consider it to be the backyard of death. And the reason why was because my great-grandfather, which I never knew, he was out here doing yard work and suffered a massive heart attack and died just while doing yard work. So that's why I call it the backyard of death, just for that particular reason. And I wasn't even born yet when he passed away, which I never got to know him. And my dad was only 9 years old when he died. So yeah, right here used to be a storage building, and see, my great-grandfather, he actually planted a garden in this yard too. He sure loved doing yard work though. Very passionate about it, which I guess I must have taken that from him, because I enjoy doing it too. Yeah. So my grandparents, they don't have the house up for sale yet. So there's no telling how long it'll be until this house will officially be for sale and will be sold. We'll get a look at the other side. Those are Nandinas right there that are practically just covering that window right there. Well, barely. And there's my car right there. Yeah, lots of good memories of this house. Yep, here's the front yard. Yep. So I definitely won't be doing no lawn cutting videos at this place anymore. This will probably be the last time y'all actually see this house. So yeah, so I think now I'm gonna head back home. Well, now I'm at the Greenwood Cemetery, because I do have some family members that are buried over here, which is over here. Yep, these are my great-grandparents. It looked like my grandmother just put some poinsettias on their gravestone, which is nice. Yep, right there, that's my great-grandfather. See, he passed away in 1966. See, my dad was only 9 years old. My great-grandmother. Reason why I'm actually over here is because, see, my great-grandmother has a birthday this week, which I think it's Friday, which she would be turning 99, which I think that's about right. And if my great-grandfather would still be alive, he would be 100. Grandmother even put flowers up for my great-great-aunt and also my great-great-uncle, which I barely even knew him. See, he passed away in 1991. So I was only 6 years old then. Yeah, but then my great-great-aunt, see, she passed away June 5th of 2014. that was just this summer. But they even put some poinsettias up too. Definitely a big cemetery, but a beautiful cemetery. Yep, sure do miss them. Well, that should be it for now. Now time to head home. My batteries are dying though, and so I hope y'all enjoyed the video. So, thanks for watching.